I don't know if I'd have the freaking balls to do that 2,000 feet up on El Cap.
This is Petzl's new Connect Adjust. They updated their OG personal inker with something that has a few people concerned. So we're going to slow pull this, drop test it, and see if it works the way they said it's going to. There are a lot of new personal inkers coming out on the market, but this is the only one that I've seen that is rope-based but has this. Let me show you what it looks like up close. So on the Evolve Adjust and most personal inkers, you're gonna see a rope loop at the bottom, but on this new one, you got this Dyneema sling that wants to be a rope lanyard, and that is how they connected it right there. This is rock hard, whereas this is squishy here, and there is a half twist in this, so it sits nicely on a belay loop. But is this safe?
The best way to know if this is safe is by reading the comment section.
Stop fear-mongering, Jan. If used as intended designed, it's fine.
Or super good enough. I prefer the original design, but I assume with the failure load being over 10 kilonewtons, it's considered safe.
For me, the Dyneema girth hitch to the belay loop, I don't like it. Not the right material.
Or my favorite, don't do dumb shit. Just go climb some rock. Stop fretting.
But Matt says it's worse because now you have a Dyneema sling cinched down really tight and rigid that's creating a focus wear point.
So you only have so many things you can worry about at a time. And what I don't think people are worried about is maybe the right thing, which we can get into a little bit later. But let's first test whether or not it breaks your belay loop.
This is a harness and we connected the belay loop to the shackle and we have this girth hitch directly to it. Let's find out what breaks first.
It's slipping. It slips around 2K in.
Ooh, that's warm. It's getting pretty bunched up on this side and it's pretty flat on this side, but that doesn't generate enough force to break anything. What if we just jam it into this guy?
Before we pull it more, I'm gonna see if we've caused any damage to the belay loop. Oh, there we go. I don't see any damage.
Let's jam it in there.
Wait, what?
Oh, there's a lot going on here. First of all, that is an interesting graph.
Oh, that's hot. this is a little warm.
Is there anything wrong with, wow, that is hot. No, that seems fine. Wait, okay, whoa. And this actually doesn't look that bad. You want to take a stab at undoing that now? Whoa, are you able to get it?
Yeah, and that looks fine.
I think I found that spot on it. So this is different looking.
Yeah, so where the rope stretched, the stitching broke. This failed lower than we were expecting. The things we expected to fail, still good.
I want to know if it's the belay loop or the Dyneema sling that breaks first, and I'm determined to find out. No way! 14.84.
There's our belay loop. There's the Dyneema sling. Our stitching's looking worse than ever.
I don't have anything to say. I'm just modeling.
I'm gonna use that in the video now.
Whoa, it broke in the knot.
I mean, that is very interesting.
Yeah, so we are able to get this off. Really see anything there that I'd call damage.
Not considering it's almost 15K in.
Which is what this is rated for. We can't find a strength rating for this anywhere. Petzl says it complies with the EN 17520 from 2021 for personal belay anchors. That standard's behind a paywall. It is our understanding that that standard, many other climbing standards, are developed with the UIAA. They have a standard for free, UIAA 109 for belay lanyards requires 15 kilonewtons in a static test.
So 5.2.3 says between two bars offering a contact radius of 5 plus or minus 0.05 millimeters to the lanyard and with the mean roughness value raw not exceeding 8 hump. What is UM in English?
Not a clue.
Audience GPT, in 75 words or less, please break down the UIAA 109 in plain English. Am I doing it wrong? Please put your answer in the comment section below. So the standard also requires a dynamic test or a drop test, and it's not about the strength of the lanyard, but how much force it applies to the anchor and that it needs to be below 10 kilonewtons.
Slow pull tests are great, but drop tests are more fun. To see if it slips, We are putting Sharpie marks right there on the top. Let's drop test this. $7,000 in. I wonder if it slipped. It did not break there though. As a wise man once said, don't do dumb shit, but don't tempt me with a good time. We're gonna drop that again with it already jammed up against the knot. Whoa, it did not break. And that was about the same as before. Oh shit, it's popping the threads. So this plastic thing's pretty messed up. There's no knot. There's like all the stitching's gone. So this is quite pinched, but nothing's cutting through. The stitching's actually in okay shape. This rope is pretty flat now, and that knot has almost no tail. Let's just do a fall factor one here and see what happens. Did it not break? So this was only a fall factor one, and it got us a higher force. One last time for good measure. Oh my God, that's scary. Oh my God, that's scary and fun at the same time. 11.18.
I think there was like a sonic boom there, like a whip crack.
Are you concerned about the Dyneema sling cutting the Belay loop?
Not even a little bit.
Look what I just found. Looks like we still have a knot. Not quite sure how it came out. Oh, I guess the rope did break.
The rope broke.
Yeah.
Before we get into the part that I am concerned with, let's see if it does what they say. If I were to girth hitch this on my harness, it is a big enough loop that it goes over at least this SMD. What I want to know is how easy it is, wow, that is smooth, to adjust. So, wow, that is butter. The things I've hated most about roped personal anchors are how rough they are. Let me show you something about the Evolve real quick. You see the Evolve Adjust, this is actually a little bit wider. The holes for the rope are a little bit wider. And this rope is a 9.5 millimeter and this is a 9 millimeter rope. So you have a thinner rope and a bigger head that it goes through. This kind of has a lot of friction and I don't actually liked these before. Can I tootle one? Well, I do need to cheat a little bit with my feet. Pretty smooth. And it holds. Now what I don't have with other personal anchors that I'm always looking for is if I am tight on this, I can push this button and lower myself, take the slack and undo this. And so if I'm hanging here, I don't wanna have to otherwise stand up and release it and go like that and try to like do that. It does suck. This is actually pretty smooth, but they claim you can be hanging on it like this and release it. They say special use aid for releasing under load. If you put a little string inside the hole that you can pull it and release under load as long as you're hanging on to the tail. The old heads had no hole, but the new heads have this 4 millimeter hole right here. They recommend you tie it like that. But in this case, we tied it like this so I can clip a carabiner to it so I can have something more to grab onto it. Now let's see with a big handle if I can release this under load, but I'm actually pretty scared. So I'm gonna just have a little slack there. Oh my God, that is, I'm not gonna do that on some small thin aid piece while I'm trying to release off to the next traversy section. Oh, I mean, it works, but God damn. How the hell are you supposed to do that with a barrel knot on the end of a 4 millimeter cord? I'm pulling with all my strength.
Now I shouldn't have to say this, but you want your carabiner to go through that hole right there and not that spot right there because it just won't work. I saw that on the user manual. I was like, that's dumb they have to put that. And then I realized that I had this Metolius Easy Daisy for years in my closet because I clipped this and it didn't work. Every time I sat back on it, it would open it up because I didn't see this hole, which is what you're actually connected to. Which in hindsight, now that I understand how gear works, this is how you release it. And I clipped it to the handle. And that's why they have to put things like that on the instructions. What else is on the instructions? That's interesting. Now they explicitly say not to clip a carabiner inside of the end knot that keeps breaking when we break test this thing. But on my Yates Daisy, it has this ring. And I use it all the time to shorten it up to create this loop that my knee gets stuck in and hoses me all the time. And I would not want to be missing that feature about this. And if I pull this down, it doesn't look like a very big hole, but They shouldn't have told me not to do that because I didn't even know a carabiner fit in that. And now I'm tempted to do that. Now, I wouldn't want a carabiner permanently in that because that would be annoying, but I think having a little tiny string in there for the few times that you just might want to pull on it is tempting. I actually don't know why Petzl says not to do that. Please tell me in the comments why you think that is. Now, I did discover a hack with this thing that I don't know if it's a feature or a bug.
So the instructions say to take your locking carabiner and rotate it and then put this rubber thing on the back so it doesn't get cross-loaded. It would prevent it from doing that. But then I discovered that feature or bug, undecided still, and it doesn't go in there. It doesn't cross-load. It doesn't matter if I lift this up and try to push it through that it doesn't go in there. That's great. That's super great. What I'm curious about is when you're wiggling and jiggling, that is this bad? Is if you lean back or fall once it sits like this and then you twist, I don't know, maybe it could open?
That's not realistic. That's just a party trick. Of course you would say that. It's dead center. Let's see if I can get it to happen on an actual hanger.
So I have been party tricking, testing this for a while, and I have struggled to get it up the gate. And what I have found though is if I get it down here for some reason, somehow pull that over there and then jiggle this enough that I could possibly...
A few moments later.
Got it with two hands. You're gonna have a 0.0001% chance of it happening, just like this Dyneema sling breaking your belay loop. But that doesn't mean we won't test it. Let's go see if this is dangerous.
Oh! All right, whatever.
Oh, it's climbing, it's climbing. Get out of there.
Whoa! Now it's finally slipping. 5K in is when it started slipping. That's so different.
I wonder why. It's in its right orientation now.
Two killing it. Let's see if you can un...
Like, not a chance.
It's releasable under load, Bobby. You're not doing it right. What happens if we pull this apart? 7 was the peak, but 5 was the first tear.
So it just unstitched it, or opened all the stitches up right there.
So were the people who originally tested that sling on a belay loop full of shit? The belay loop lost! How did we accomplish that last time? Because it cut through the belay loop.
This is much skinnier than this. Both Dyneema.
I mean, if I was just going to stand here and guess, it didn't look like that big of a deal to us at the beginning. It looked like it was going to cut through. Maybe this is just an extra strong belay loop.
And maybe, let's see.
That would be funny.
The sling we're going to use is really skinny from Otsun. It's their 8mm Dyneema sling. It's my favorite one. We have over 1,000 of them that I like them so much, and I think they're such a good price. Let's see if this cuts through the belay loop.
What?
We had a super belay loop here.
I thought science was repeatable.
It clearly did more damage.
We did the previous test with the Corax. This Corax has already been tested, failed there. So we have very clean science when we try to break test this loop.
Is the condition of it good?
Yeah.
It looks good. So let's see if...
Hey! Science is repeatable.
So that's a lower number, but the same result as last time, which is fascinating when you do science the right way.
I wouldn't make any claims to doing it the right way. We got a little damage on the sling here. The funny thing is, this is a harness for adults. This is a harness for children.
So if a thinner Dyneema sling than this will break a thinner belay loop at 11 to 14 kilonewtons, then a thicker one is probably not going to break your belay loop when this is probably going to break first. So I'd hate to tell you, you watch this whole video to find out this is super good enough. Every freaking video is that conclusion.
So I'm not worried about this at all. I mean, even aggressive misuse.
Don't do it. Don't do dumb shit.
If you are interested in getting a Kinect Adjust, we have hundreds of them, and we will be giving one of them away in this Saturday's newsletter. But if you would like to see how a bunch of other personal anchors perform, we did slow pulls and drop tests in this other helpful video that you can go check out next.
Oh no! That's not ideal.